Hello and welcome to this week's VOX POP program here on BRT. And today we are in Guinea and we are at the Round Tower and we are talking to Richard Chamberlain. Sit back and enjoy this week's VOX POP program. Today we are in the Round Tower in Guinea and we are talking to Richard Chamberlain. Hi, how are you?
Oh, I'm fine, thank you. Yeah, thank you very much.
Richard, it's a pleasure to meet you. And Richard, before we start, you have a signing here today.
Yeah.
You have a calendar signing and a book signing.
That's right, yeah, thanks.
And before we come into that, I'd like to turn back the clock. You were here in Cyprus in the 1950s. Could you explain about that? Was it the 1950s?
1954, yeah. 1954. My twin brother and I joined the army under the National Service arrangement, and we joined the Royal Signals, and we were sent to Cyprus. And in May 28th, 1954, and of course when we arrived, I mean we hadn't only young men, and we hadn't been anywhere, and we just thought that we'd arrived in paradise. So
couldn't believe it.
No, it was fantastic. The weather and the surroundings and everything, you know. And obviously we had to get on with our work, but we had quite a bit of time off because in the army. And I think it used to be like that here, that midday or 1 o'clock, everything used to stop. And they thought it was too hot for the soldiers to work in the afternoon. So, of course, I used to get the camera out and start going down to either Famagusta or wherever I could and start taking pictures of whatever I could.
Where were you based?
I was based at a place called 4 Mile Point. I think they'd call it Ayas Nikolaos, just outside Famagusta. 4 miles outside, they called it 4 Mile Point at the time, and they had a Royal Signals station there, and we were based there. And of course there was no buses at that time, but we used to just have to stand outside the camp, and if a lorry or whatever came along, asked for a lift, you know.
You were hitchhiking.
Yes, hitchhiking. Yeah, but funny enough, after we'd been there a little while. I think it was a Turkish Cypriot, or it might have been a Greek Cypriot, but somebody started up a bus to take us from, to Famagusta. Well, I think they were Turkish Cypriots, and the funny thing was, soon afterwards, a Greek Cypriot. I think it was I can't remember his name now. But anyway, he started up as well. And the buses used to race each other to Farbigusta to pick up so that they could get to the bus stop before the others and pick up the fares and that. And yeah. then as soon as they stopped, the other one used to tear up the road and try and get in front of them to pick up the passengers and the fares and that sort of thing. And it used to be quite funny to see us all racing up and down the road.
Before we're going to talk about the 1950s again, but if we turn back the clock, back in the UK, you've done your national service here in Cyprus, and then you went back. Could we talk about that? What you did back in the UK until this age?
Yeah, well, I was originally apprenticed in the printing industry when I was 16. And then they allowed you to leave and go in the army when you were 18 for 2 years. But or you could have it deferred until you was like finished your apprenticeship. But being as my twin brother, Michael, he wanted to go in and get it over and done with, I thought I might as well go in with him. And we both went into the army. And then when I came out, I had to go back to the printing industry and finish off my apprenticeship. And then I finished off my apprenticeship. And just about that time, in those days, we used to set by lead, single letters of lead, you know, set in and out of the case, one A, and all that. And used to get quite good at it. Anyway, used to make the...
What did you print?
We used to print magazines or stationery, all sorts of... I was apprenticed in London, and it was a sort of a general... printers who would set and print anything. And then when I came out of the army, I had to go back. And after that, when I finished my apprenticeship, just at that time, the photo setting new processes were starting. So I learnt that. And then myself and two others started up a printing company, a typesetting and printing company in Clerkenwell in London, called Focus Photoset, and because it gradually built up, and then in the end we employed about 60 men, and it was quite successful. And then I went on to do that for quite a while, but I'm always one to try and do something different as well.